Hey guys, today I'm going to give you my impressions on three of the more popular headphone amplifier and DA converters. These are relatively entry level. They are all under $300, and they're quite portable. So I thought I'd give you my impressions on the three and see which one I like best, and you guys can check it out for yourself. So to my left here is the HRT HeadStreamer. This is a $139 box. It's a relatively small box. And then in the middle here is the Audioengine D1. It retails for $169 in the US. And then to my right is the Audioquest Dragonfly. It's the newest kid on the block. It retails for $249, which is the most expensive one here in this lineup. Now let's take a look at the HeadStreamer first. As you can see, it's a relatively small box. It's about the size of my palm. It's a good design, all metal, so it's a well-made. And it's got a mini USB, and then you have a headphone amplifier. Headphone output. It supports 24 bits, 96 kilohertz. It's got the lights here to tell you which sample rate you're at. Comes with a short little USB cable, which I like a lot. I don't know who makes the cable, but it's fine for $139. You can't ask for much. I believe it is made in the U.S. The sound quality on this is pretty smooth, nothing spectacular. I like the sound quality a lot, but for the price, you know, you really can't beat it. It sure sounds better than the internal DA converter of your MacBook or your computer. The headphone amplifier is not extremely strong. It's about 150 milliwatts, but it's fine. It's better than an iPod or a headphone out of your laptop. It's a good device for $139. Now the Audioengine D1 retails for $169. It has a lot of features. It also comes with a USB cable now, but this one has a standard USB output here, or input. So it's a gold plated cable. I don't know who makes the cable, but it's a high quality one. It's got optical input, and then you have your RCA outputs. This is unbalanced RCA, and you have your volume knob. Before I forget, the HeadStreamer, the volume is controlled by your computer. So you just turn up and down the volume from the keyboard. This one has its own volume knob for the amp, and I like that a lot. Makes it a lot very convenient. You don't have to reach up and locate the volume controls on your keyboard. It does have a power switch for the on-off, and the USB does power the unit. It's a great sounding unit. I think it has a lot of features for the money. You can connect this to an external CD player and power it through a USB power cable. So this is a good product. The sound's really nice. It's very, very detailed, a good bass, and I like the sound for $169. It's a good one. Now the Dragonfly is a new kid on the block here. It's very simple. Just got the USB input here, or output, whatever you call it, and then you just slide it into your USB jack, and then you have your line out or headphone amplifier. Headphone out. It's of the three, I think this one sounds the best, in my opinion. The sound quality is very neutral. The bass is very quick and tight. I really like the sound quality of this. However, it is the most expensive one here, and very little features, as you can see. And now I do have one gripe about this unit. I'll show you real quick on my laptop. Now this one does have an analog volume, so you just have to connect, adjust the volume through your laptop or your computer. Now as you can see here, it sticks out a little bit. It's not flushed against the computer. That's the only gripe I have with it. It is a bit loose, as you can see. I think if it's flushed against the laptop, I think it would be a better connection. So I hope that AudioQuest is listening and then maybe change that in the design. Other than that, it's a good unit. I really like that it's very portable, and you can just toss it into a bag. It's the size of a USB stick thumb drive, and you're off. You know, it's a good little device. None of these units need a driver for the Mac. It's plug and play, so I like that a lot. Now, in terms of which is the winner here of the three, I have to say the Audioengine, because the Audioengine, for the money, it sounds fantastic. It has a lot of features. I wish that it was more portable, but ultimately, sound quality and features really wins on this one, and the price too. Even though the Dragonfly, it sounds better than the Audioengine, I'm not sure if it's $70 better. And the lack of features on the Dragonfly really makes it very limited. Now, in terms of portable, if you're looking for a portable amplifier and DAC, which is the winner here, of course, obviously is the Dragonfly. It's a one little stick design, so there's really not much to it. Yeah, it's a very portable amp. I think that, you know, if you can afford it, this is a good one to go with. And otherwise, the Audioengine is the winner here. I think that sound quality, features, portable, it's a no-brainer. It's a great headphone amplifier and DAC. And I think that you should go check it out for yourself. The HeadStreamer, I mean, it's good, but for a little bit more money, you know, you can get the Audioengine. So the HeadStreamer is really the least I like of the bunch. But you know, if you can't afford the Audioengine, the HeadStreamer is a good start. It doesn't sound bad at all. It sounds significantly better than your internal DA converter or amplifier of your laptop or a Mac. So I think that you should definitely look at least the HRT HeadStreamer. But the ultimate would be the Dragonfly. So I hope you guys like this quick impressions and overview of the three of the most popular portable solutions. And please subscribe if you like my channel, and I hope to bring you guys more videos in the future. Check out some of the older videos that I have, a lot of gems in there. So if you haven't do so, check them out, and make sure you thumbs up on my videos, and we'll see you guys again next time. Bye-bye.